here. Take the baby bag. Thanks to my job. Thanks to my job. Oh God. It really sucks that I have to make a video to prove that this damage that was done to my life is real, and that my friend betrayed me and sent this video out to the public of something so hurtful. But be real, the damage is real. It's, you know, the glass is gone, the broken glass is cleaned up, and but the damage is still here. It's still here. Things that have to be, this is an apartment, I have to fix this. And it's not funny, my son is 6 foot tall, he's not 12, he's 15. And he's 270 pounds, so no, I can't spank him. And he's mentally ill. So, yeah, it's real. So I guess everybody's saying they want to know who it is. Okay, so now you know it's me. It's me, it's my son, it's my house. No, he's not 12. It wasn't over a cell phone. He's 15, he's 6 foot tall, and he's 270 pounds. So no, I couldn't spank him. You know, we try to clean up as much, but yeah, the damage is real. The window is still broken out. The marble is still broken. Not going away immediately. So, I don't know what anybody wants from me. My son is mentally ill. I've dealt with this for 15 years, and it just sucks that I trusted someone and they sent the video out, and now everyone is looking at my hurt.
The Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today we gather to speak about this whole viral video that's been going on about the 12-year-old that destroyed his mother's house because she took away his cell phone. Allegedly. Now, I say allegedly because y'all got it all wrong according to the title of this video. Now, if my voice sounds a little off, that's because it is. Because I'm sick. I'm sick as all hell. And I'm still filming this video. And the reason I'm filming this video right now is because I don't feel right, okay? this video does not sit right with my spirit because a lot of people are spreading the most vile misinformation, and I just felt like I had to get this video out here for y'all today, okay? Now, first things first, as you guys see in the beginning clips of this video, the mother of this child has spoken out. So, one, this child is not 12 years old. Two, this child is actually mentally ill. This child is not ill-mannered because the child has been raised improperly or anything of the sort. And three, y'all need to learn how to actually gather information before y'all start going around just saying shit for clout. Clout is legitimately the new crack, and I need us to do better as human beings, okay? You guys have been flooding my DMs, my emails with so much of the clips from these viral videos, and I was like, listen, not only am I sick, but I'm tired, okay? And I was really waiting to see if more information came out about this, and it did. And when I saw that the child was like 15 and not 12, and that the child was mentally ill, I was like, okay, we need to talk about this because this is getting a little out of hand, all right? And I also came across the GoFundMe, and I am going to link it down below. They have reached their target, but of course, it is still open. If you guys do want to donate to it, feel free to donate to it, because definitely I do feel for this lady, and like, it's definitely important that we do help these people if we're gonna make videos about them, if we're gonna talk about them, pass judgment on them, and whatever the case may be. Jesus Christ. I'll tell y'all right now, if I sound crazy, if I'm coughing throughout this video, please forgive me, because I haven't filmed in almost 2 weeks now, and like, I really feel like hell. Like, I just been walking around gratte santé for like 2 weeks. Okay, I've been taking a shower, so I'm not gratte santé, but like, I don't feel my best, but I feel good enough to make this video. So now, from what I understand and what I gathered from social media posts, it was someone that this mother sent this video to, whether a friend of some sort, that actually posted this video on social media, and the story went viral. The mother actually spoke out about this situation, okay? She said that this situation had absolutely nothing to do with a cell phone like everyone is saying. Her child is mentally ill. The child had a mental breakdown and literally started ravaging the house. She took a video, she sent it to someone that she trusted. That person then turned around and put the video out on social media and capitalized off of it. And now she is forced to explain what happened. To be quite honest with you, I have no idea who this person was, what their motive is, but that is just really one of the most disgusting things I probably ever heard in my entire life. Like, why would you do something like that? This woman's not an influencer, she's not a public figure. This is just someone that you should care about as a friend, not to go and post a fucking business on the internet. But hey, that's neither here or there. And according to the GoFundMe page, she's been through a lot, okay? Not only is her son mentally ill, but he refuses to take his medication. Now, according to the GoFundMe page that someone else organized for her and other posts on social media, the kid is 15 years old, 270 pounds, and 6 foot tall. So who's about to stop this child from doing what he did to this house? That's what I need. Who? Miss Cornette. Not I said the fox. Not I said the male. I was never. And also, according to the GoFundMe page, she just recently relocated to Florida and lost everything while moving and had to work from the bottom up to regain everything that she lost. So this lady has gone through a lot, okay? She also has a daughter, and while all of this was going on, her daughter was like locked in a room. So I can imagine how her daughter felt while all of this was going on. So just when you get a little bit more of the details and you get more context, this is not something that people should be just going out and making assumptions about and just going based off of social media and making shit up, saying that the kid is fucking 12 and the kid is just some badass kid that needs to be kicked out, thrown into boarding school, and beat the fuck up, or whatever the case is that y'all are saying about this kid. Now, I understand that clearly clearly people could only go based off of what is put out onto social media and whatever that person that clearly is not that lady's friend said. Ooh, child. However, I need y'all to understand, YouTubers, Instagrammers, TikTokers, whatever the case may be, y'all can't just go out and make videos and make content based off of one post, okay? Y'all need to learn how to wait to make content. Y'all could at least contact the person that y'all see the video first come from. Like, this is why when you guys be like, make a video, make a video, make a video, make a post, make a this, I don't. Okay, I wait a good minute because I'm not about to be out here just making content, making videos, making whatever the case may be. And the next thing you know, I gotta amend whatever it is I said. Now I gotta interview the person. Now I gotta this, now I gotta that. Because now, look at all of this shit. Now there's all of these videos, all of these posts spreading misinformation about something. And I would hate if that was me, if I was this woman. Now I have to sit here and see people talking about my situation that is completely false. Put yourself in these people's shoes. Put yourself in these people's position. That is just messed up in every which way. Y'all act like y'all not human for real. Even though I always say social media and the internet isn't real, right? I always say social media ain't a thing, like it's just social media. But at the same time, the people behind the screen are real. Social media does change lives. Social media has taken lives. And this woman is going through a lot. I can only imagine what this child is going through. And what y'all need to understand is this child is mentally ill. I'm mentally ill. And mental illness is not an excuse to act a certain way. But not only is this child mentally ill, the child is also a child. You don't necessarily understand 100% what you're doing when you're a child. You also need to understand that when you're acting to this type of degree, your mental illness is something that needs to be taken care of with the swiftness. He's not only a danger to himself, he's a danger to his family. He's probably a danger to society at this point because that house is unreal. Do y'all see that house? It looks like 3 or 4 grown men came into that house and tore it apart. Like, it looks like a home invasion. One 15-year-old child did that. This is not funny. This is not a game. This is not a situation where you're like, oh, well, this kid needs his ass beat. This is not a situation where you should be making jokes and just making snarky comments. Like, I was seeing so many horrible comments like, oh, well, she raised that demon. Well, she raised him to be that way. And this is the thing. I've made so many comments about, like, horrible kids acting out and, you know, kids making comments to their parents in certain ways or just being bad. Because I've worked with really horrible kids in my lifetime. And most of the time, all those kids need is some TLC. Okay, they just need somebody to talk to them. They need someone to understand them. But when mental illness is at play, they need way more than that. And I don't understand how anyone could have saw something like that and thought, oh, well,
that's a badass kid. His mother did that.
Oh, you just need a father in the home.
And just, like, is that really? Like, y'all really think these kids are that bad? Like, no, okay? A kid talking back, a kid fighting, a kid doing some drugs, a kid smoking some weed, a kid skipping school. That's normal circumstances, okay? That's normal. Not normal, but normal. Y'all know what I mean? Like, that's regular kid rebellion. But, like, this shit right here, that's beyond normal child rebellion. Okay, like that's not regular shit. I would definitely love to talk to this lady. I would love to interview her. That's something I'm thinking about doing on this channel, like interviews and talking to people that have went through like viral situations, because no one ever gets to hear their side. You know, no one ever gets to talk to them and see what they've been through and see what their situation is. But at the same time, I felt it when she said, you know, now everyone's seeing her hurt. You know, now everyone's seeing her situation. Now everyone's seeing her personal problems, her child's personal problems on display. And it was never meant to be that way. Someone went and put her shit out on the internet and it was never supposed to be there. And honestly, that's just not right. So that is something I would like to do. If any of you guys know her personally, or if you know her at, I would love to reach out to her. So definitely hit me up on Instagram. It's always on the screen, or email me. I'll deeply appreciate it. So of course, I know you guys love my hoodie because we are all overworked and overpaid. You would get my hoodie in my Media Hustle shop. Media Hustle is my company that I started to help you guys reach your goals online and on social media. If you want to be a YouTuber or an influencer of any of the sorts, if you want your company to do better online, I can help you do that. As a matter of fact, I do have a webinar coming up on October 7th at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It is only $25. However, if you can't afford it or you can't make it, there will be a live replay for you. But if it is not in the budget, make sure you guys join the free live Q&A where you guys can ask me anything regarding growing your audience on YouTube, on Facebook. Make sure you guys register for free on the Facebook link. Again, it is linked down below. I can't wait to see you guys. It means a lot to me if you guys go and you register. That will be taking place the day before on October 6th. 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. It's gonna be lit. Okay, it's gonna be lit. I can't wait to see y'all. And of course, make sure you guys follow Media Hustle Co. or my personal page for updates. Now, listen, I'm just saying this right now. Okay, this is just an assumption because we did not see a father. There was no mention of the father. I didn't see a mention of the father in the GoFundMe. I could probably go check. I'm not sure. But I'm assuming this is a single mother household. Now, of course, whether your child is mentally ill or not, there's a lot of reasons why a child could act like this. Now, I personally don't understand why people automatically hear someone or a child is mentally ill, they automatically think, oh, mentally ill, that means the child or the person has lost all mental control, okay? That means that this child doesn't know what they're doing, all things are out the window, that means that this person don't know a damn thing. Understand, hello, I'm mentally ill, okay? Bipolar, anxiety, PTSD, ADHD, you know, seasonal depression, and I got all of that. Do you guys think I'm out of my right motherfucking mind? I'm able to work social media full time. I'm able to own a business. I'm able to do a lot of things. I'm in a full-blown, committed, healthy relationship here. Do you guys think that I'm out of my mind? Just because somebody's mentally ill does not absolve them of responsibility, does not absolve them from being able to have or need to have healthy relationships. So that goes to my first point, not having a two-parent household. It's no secret, right? If you don't have a two-parent household, that can more than likely hinder your success in life, okay? Yeah, hey! Don't yell at me. Don't yell at me. I know there's going to be so many people with your little fingers. What does having a father have to do with anything? What would him having a father have anything to do with this? Listen, I don't understand why so many of you guys refuse to understand that if you don't have a mother, or you don't have a father, or in general, if you don't have a village, that can hinder you from having the life that you're meant to have. I think that that's pretty much common sense, right? You know how they say it takes a village? Well, it takes two to tango, okay? And without the other one, there's no tango. It's more of a solo guiad. You know, it's just one. Like, I don't understand why. Like, listen, I understand. There are so many men out there that just leave children high and dry, and there's a lot of women that are left, take care of the children, and most of the time, women do the best they can. And most of the time, these children turn out great, okay? Perfectly fine. They need for nothing. But a lot of the time, they need for a lot. Would that mean that the child doesn't end up mentally ill? No. Would that mean that the child would probably turn out completely different? Maybe, maybe not. We wouldn't know. Maybe men, you should take care of your fucking kids and we wouldn't have to deal with all of it. But what I mean is the father's presence can mean a lot. A lot of the times, What y'all need to understand is, if you're gonna have this whole situation of, oh, well, I don't need a dad, the dad ain't shit, I'm not gonna let the father be in the child's life, blah, 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 blah. Father wants to be there. A lot of the times, you're doing more harm than good. I've also been with a couple of men that were in single father households. Have you ever been with a man with mommy issues? Y'all complain about men with daddy issues? Nah. Try being with a man with mommy issues. It's terrifying. Nonetheless, both parents are fucking vital. You can say that you can do it by yourself all you want. It's going to affect the child. Okay? It took two to make them. Why do you think it's not going to take two to raise them? What do you think this is? And then that leads me to my next point. A lot of you guys have this horrible, terrible habit of, you are the man of the house now. Since there's no dad here, especially you guys do this to the oldest sons or just all the boys in the house, you are the man of the house now. And you know what that does to the son? It makes them stressed. Okay, it puts all the world on their shoulders. It makes them feel not only overwhelmed, but some boys, it makes them feel entitled. It makes them feel like they can do whatever the hell they want. They can act however the hell they want. They can talk to you however the hell they want. They can talk to whoever else however the hell they want. You know why? Because they're the man of the house. And eventually they feel like they're the man of the world. And then they get into friendships, relationships, jobs, school, whatever the case may be, and they feel like, I'm the man of whatever. And this is a problematic, toxic thing that you guys are not understanding, that you are instilling into your boys, that you're instilling into your sons. And y'all don't understand it. Like, y'all think, oh, okay, I'm giving my son responsibility. I'm telling him he's the man of the house, because he is the man of the house. He's the only testosterone here. You know, it's only me, the daughter, and the son or whatever, whether he's mentally ill or not. Like I'm saying, I'm not saying this is what this woman did. Talking on a very general plane here, okay? A lot of y'all will sit here on this whole, you're the man of the house, seu mesmo que garçom guy, okay? Y'all sit here like, yeah, mija, you are the man, you are the son, you are the father, the padre, because there's no other man here. And then this boy gets big-headed and thinks he could do whatever the fuck he wants, and then he gets violent. Okay, he gets rude, he gets disrespectful, and then all of a sudden, we don't understand why this boy is acting the way he's acting. Stop that shit, kill that noise, let that boy be a boy. It's the same shit that a lot of y'all do to y'all daughters. Y'all let y'all daughters act like the mother, watching all the kids, doing all the chores, doing the grocery shopping, doing nepotekwa, and then you get confused as to why they fucking and sucking at 12. Remember, she's the woman of the house. She's the mother. You gave her woman responsibilities, and then you're confused as to why she's acting like a woman. Let your kids be kids. You do your womanly and your fatherly duties. Watch your fucking kids. Take care of your fucking kids. Y'all are stressing me the hell out. Y'all really are. I just don't understand. And then y'all be like, Ella, you're not a mom. You don't understand. I don't have to be a mom to use common sense. I've been a kid before. Friends that went through this. Cousins that went through this. Other people in the neighborhood that's went through this. Kids that have gotten their whole lives ruined. Because I can't play basketball. I have to watch my little brother and sister. I can't do debate club. I have to watch my little brother and sister. I have to babysit. I have to do this, that, and the third. Couldn't get scholarships. Couldn't do this, that, and the third. Couldn't learn track. Couldn't do anything. And their parents thought of it as, oh, that's just bullshit. That's school shit. That's fun shit. Oh, you have to help me because I have to do a triple shift, whatever the case may be. Not saying this is what the lady did, but But this is what a lot of parents tend to do. Now, when it comes to children being mentally ill, I feel like this is actually one of the saddest things to watch, right? Now, I worked at a pediatric office forever. I talked about this a couple times on my channel, literally from when I was like 15 up until the pandemic started. And there was a lot of children that had mental health issues, kids that were special needs, all of that. Some of them were special needs from the time they were born. Some of them, you saw it slowly develop. And I will say that the lack of independence was something that those kids hated more than anything. They hated being doted after. They hated their parents taking phones away from them. They hated parents limiting time away from their friends. They hated parents telling them what to do, telling them where to go. It was very, very interesting because a lot of times as parents, as friends, as family, when we have friends that are special needs or friends that we know that are mentally ill to the point where we know that they can be harmed by other people or that other people are ignorant, we want to protect them, right? Like we don't want them to like go somewhere and people to take advantage of them. But for the most part, a lot of people who are mentally ill or special needs, they're not handicapped. And if they are handicapped, right? They're very independent. If they are independent, that makes sense, right? And even if they're not independent by societal standards, they can do a lot of things that we think that they can't. We just have to allow them to. For example, there was a girl that was at the doctor's office. I'm just gonna have to give her a completely different diagnosis. So just in case, because I feel like she might watch my videos. Because a lot of people watch my videos that I didn't know watch my videos. So let's just say she had... Okay, I'm not going to say it because it's going to be hard. But she had a disease where most people that have this disease, more than likely, they really should be supervised. However, she was very, very independent, but her parents were very, very afraid to leave her by herself. They didn't want her to go places by herself. They didn't want her to have friends. They didn't want her to really even go to a normal school, but they babied the hell out of her. Her parents were insanely controlling. They didn't let her speak for herself. They didn't let her make her own choices, such as food. They didn't let her go out. They were very, very keen on making her dependent on them. And it got very, very suffocating for her. Y'all, it got so bad that I remember the first time I heard her like really talk in full sentences, I was shook. I was like, oh my God, you could talk. Like, that's how crazy what it is. Like, that's how like controlling her parents were, because like they would not let her speak. She was very independent, okay? She could talk. She listened to music. She was like a regular girl, that can do everything that girls her age can do. But her parents didn't see that. Her parents wanted to baby her. They practically wanted to spoon feed her. It was ridiculous. It was insane. It was unnecessary. Okay, her parents wanted her to be in the house, in her bed, eating applesauce, and she wanted to go to the club. She wanted to wear weave. She wanted to have a hot girl life. Okay, like she literally wanted to wear crop tops and weave and do all the things the young girls were doing. And then eventually she wanted to move to her grandmother's house in another state where she could do all the things that she wanted to do. Long story short, she eventually like escaped or whatever and moved to another state where she could be more free. She ended up resenting her parents, and it was a whole thing. It was a whole deal. It was drama on drama on drama. And it's crazy because a lot of people from the outside looking in saw her as a frail, you can't do anything for yourself because you're special needs and you have this disease. But the girl was perfectly fine, and it was crazy because like they highly medicated the girl. They were doing the most, and it's like the girl was perfectly fine. Like, kid, she was perfectly fine. Like, when you actually spoke to her, when you actually interacted with her, she was perfectly fine. It was her parents. Oh yeah, I have to tell you guys, it's not like she had Munchausen's or something. Like, she really did have like a legitimate disability. It just was not as severe as her parents were making it seem. They just really wanted to protect her, is all. That were just babying her, and they were worried for her. And as a parent, I understand, you're worried for your child. You don't want anything to happen to your child. You don't want anyone to take advantage of your child. But at the same time, it's like, let your kid live. Let your kids live. Sometimes, whether consciously or subconsciously, you baby your kids, okay? You smother your kids. You don't let your kids live the life that they're meant to live because you're scared, you know? Or you think that taking things away from them or disciplining them is actually helping them, when actually sometimes it's not. I'm not saying don't discipline your kids, but understand what your kid actually needs and why you're disciplining them, and find a way to discipline them in the way they need to be disciplined, right? So if your kid has special needs or mentally ill, or if your kid is acting out and not mentally ill, if your kid is promiscuous or doing drugs, whatever it is, you have to discipline that child based on whatever it is that they're doing and based on their personality type. Can't discipline a child is doing drugs and acting out the same way that you would discipline a kid that is like autistic. Okay, y'all understand where I'm coming from? Like, some people just see shit the same way. Oh, well, that kid hit me, well, I'm gonna do this to them. It's like, well, if a child is autistic and they hit you, can't discipline that child the same way as a kid that's like promiscuous and got mad at you for going to drag them out of their boyfriend house and they hit you. You feel me? Like, there, it's different things, you know? A lot of people just like read a parenting book, or they see what their friend did to their kid that was doing this, and they just discipline them the same way, you know? And again, I'm not a parent, but like, listen, when I'm telling you kids have run away to my house all my life, and I've had friends that do so much shit, and then next thing you know, I'm in the middle of this, and I gotta go to their parents' house and beg their parents to fucking take them back. And child, the shit that I went through with certain people, it's just like, Jesus, I should have went to childhood psychology at this point, you know? So it's just, it's a lot. Now, of course, there's also the route of just sending your kid away, okay? Sending them to boarding school, sending them to wilderness therapy camps. And I'm gonna just tell you this right now, don't take it from me, take it from Google, okay? And take it from any other search engine you want. These childhood therapy camps, these boarding schools do not have the best reputations, okay? I feel like that should be the dead last resort. Like, I'm talking about the kid trying to kill you, DJ, because those types of places do not have the best reputation, okay? Those schools have a bad reputation of people literally passing away. SA. It's so much worse, okay? I actually want to do an in-depth video about that, because just, you did not sound lit. Those kids that end up going to those types of schools end up coming back worse, okay? Those kids that end up going away, getting sent away by their parents, never come back happy, okay? I don't know any kid that comes back from any of these types of programs, military school even, is like,
thank you so much, mom and dad, for sending me away when I was being bad as shit.
I don't know. If you're foreign, I know there's a lot of parents that tend to, you know, send their kids away to Africa, to Haiti, you know, to Asia. And it's just like, I don't understand. Like, every kid I know that's been sent to Haiti has come back worse than they were before. Just don't do it. Just don't do it, okay? Because first of all, Haitians, when they see kids come from America, they treat them like royalty. Okay, that's one. So they're not gonna learn a damn thing except how to come back and be worse. And on top of that, it's just like, kids don't do well when they know they're being shipped away for being bad, okay? Kids don't do well when they know my parent doesn't want me anymore. My parent has given up on me. More than likely, if a kid is acting out, if a kid is being bad, if a kid more than likely doesn't know what they're doing because they are mentally ill or there are special needs of any way, they don't understand what they're doing. So why would you send them away? Like, it doesn't make sense. If you're gonna put them in a mental institution, I think that's, you know, that's fair. But then if they're to this degree where they acted like this kid acted, what do you think they're gonna do? All they're gonna do is pump them up with drugs. So do your research. You really have to do your research, a lot of research. And that brings me to my last one, which is drugs. Child, the drugs. This one's, that's a doozy. I've known a lot of kids to be on drugs. A lot of kids to be on drugs. I don't know. I've known some kids where the drugs helped, but they're mild cases. Like, the kid had a little ADHD, they give him a pill a day, keeps the ADHD away. I've known some kids to be schizophrenic. They put them on drugs and they trying to kill the parents in the sleep. Same thing with autism. Therefore, Honestly, I would say research these drugs. Not all kids respond well to certain drugs. But also, taking drugs, just like with any mental illness, you need to understand you have to research closely what these drugs do and how they affect your child. How do these drugs feel in your child's system? Are they making them happy? Are they making them angry? Are they making them tired? Are they making them productive? Because not all drugs are happy drugs, okay? Not all drugs are actually gonna help the symptoms. Some of them may aggravate your child, you know? So you gotta be very, very careful what you're giving your child. I've seen so many kids be way worse with these types of medications, you know, like it really, really, really does depend. It also depends on just the genetic makeup of your kid too. So it's just, there's a lot. And then of course, as this lady did say, the child does refuse to take the medication. There's no telling if the child's gonna take the medication or not, right? If the child gets old enough and they're like, I don't wanna take the medication anymore, then what will you do? Now you guys probably could go, okay, well, why would the child refuse? And plus, I'm the child's parent. How are they gonna refuse to take the medication? Well, at the end of the day, the child still has rights as a human. And plus, yeah, the child could just fuck around and flush your shit down the toilet. The child could hold that shit under its tongue, eat a muffin, and go to the fucking toilet and spit the pill out. You know, so technically, you know, there's a lot of things that could happen. So with that being said, y'all need to really, really be mindful and be very, very careful. Not everybody is cut out for the parenting, especially in 2022 and beyond. These kids are different. There's so many things that can happen. There's so much things in the food. There's so many things in the air. There's so many things in the water. There's so many things that can trigger and affect children more than ever before. It's not the 80s. It's not the 90s. It's not 1922. Okay? There's so many things that are affecting these kids like never before. And y'all need to be very, very careful about having children, taking care of children. It's not about just willy-nilly having kids for fun anymore. Okay, wrap it up, especially because they're trying to pee on the rights right now. And if you have the right to terminate and you want to exercise that right, I said what I said. I'm still the Mademoiselle, and I'm gonna say what you're thinking. With that being said, it was so hard to hold that call. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Again, I would really love to talk to that lady because I really do feel for her and I would love to hear more of her story. If you know her information, please email me or send me her information to my DM on Instagram. Like I said, it's always on the screen and or my description or pinned comment. If you made it all the way to the end of this video, drop it down below a heart emoji. Make sure you guys go and you subscribe to the channels, okay? I have a Haitian channel where I talk about voodoo, politics, and folklore from a Haitian American perspective. I also have a personal channel trying to get to 10k. So why don't we get there? Well, what y'all doing, okay? Where I talk about my personal life, lifestyle videos, things like that. And yeah, everything is linked down below. Make sure you guys subscribe to all three channels. I know a lot of you guys be like stumbling across these other channels. You guys think it's the same channel? It's not the same channel. It's three separate channels. Three separate topics. Get into it. Get into it. I don't understand what y'all doing. Jesus Christ. Y'all embarrassing, bro. Come on now. Give up the program. Give up the program. Thank you. Almost broken down. Thank you guys so much for watching. You said that already. Yeah, like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Bye!